Hello, stylish coders. My name is Sean, and I will be your instructor for this entire course. The name of this course is Python for Beginners, and this is the first lesson, in fact. In this course, we will learn what Python is, learn why we should learn Python, learn the daily implementations of Python, and get that great fundamental block on your journey to being a web developer or a software engineer or whatever it is you'd like to be. So, the first question, what is Python? Python is a simple but high-level programming language that is used very commonly in machine learning and artificial intelligence, data analysis, and even web development. And speaking of web development, by the end of this course, you will be able to make a website. Isn't that incredible? So, why should we learn Python? Well, Python, as I said earlier, has a lot of daily implementations. Throughout this course, and as days pass, you will notice that Python is actually used a lot in our computers, in our phones, and even some things you wouldn't expect, like a random microchip. So, let's get started. The first thing we're going to do in this lesson is, of course, download Python itself. So as you can see, I am on python.org, and you can just go ahead and in your web browser and just type python.org, and you will land at this interface. What you're going to do is hover your button over the downloads button, and it should have given you a link to download Python 3 for your operating system. If it does get it wrong, then you can go ahead and click All Releases, and it will give you Python for Windows, Linux, and Mac. So it got mine right, so I'm going to go ahead and click the Download Python 3.8.3 button right here, and I'm going to go ahead and open it. Okay. Windows users, listen up. This does not affect Linux or Mac users, but Windows users, really listen up on this one. Do you see this little button here called Add Python 3 to Path? Be sure to click that button. If you do not click that button, you will have problems. If you're on Linux or Mac, again, this you will not have to click any button of the sort. But if you are on Windows, be sure to click that button or this will not work for you. Once you do that, just go ahead and click Install Now and it will begin installing. This will take a little bit, I would say about 2 minutes, so I'm going to go ahead and fast forward this. Okay guys, so as you can see, Python is just about installed now. We should be ready in just a second. And while that does finishing touches, I'm going to go ahead and show you something else. This is the other thing we're going to download. I assure you, after this, we're not going to have to download anything. This is the last thing. What we're going to do is jetbrains.com/PyCharm. That's jetbrains.com/PYCHARM. So go ahead and click enter into your web browser. In just a second, it'll take you here. And so you should see the big download button in the dead center. And you're going to go ahead and click that. And then you should come here. And as you can see, there are buttons for Windows, Mac, and Linux for their respective download links. And as you can also see, there is a professional link and a community link. The professional link is for a paid version, which has some additional features, but we're not going to use any of those, so we're going to go ahead and download the community one. So go ahead and click download whenever you're ready. I'm not ready yet because I would prefer that Python downloads first. Remember, guys, especially if your computer is slow, try to download one thing at a time or else both things will download very, very slowly. So I will get back to you in just a minute when Python is ready. In the meantime, hold tight. Hey guys, it's been about like 5 seconds. Very, very short. Did not expect it to be ready that quick. But Python is done. And there are a couple of buttons, but you really do not need to click any of those unless you're really, really interested. And be sure not to click this one because that's really going to have a problem. So go ahead and click close once you're ready. And then again, just go ahead and download the community version. This is going to take a second, so I will get back to you in just a second. Okay, so we're ready. Here we go. We're going to go ahead and click it to download it. And here we are. You should be led here. And you're really just going to click next, next, next. There's not really anything so specific you have to do. And you're really just going to wait for this to install. Now, I have heard some problems with this. And a lot of the times those problems are actually not like solvable. So if you really are really having trouble with PyCharm and there just seems no way out, then you can use IDLE. If you can download PyCharm, certainly do. But if you really can't, you're 100% sure there's pretty much no way you can, then just go ahead and open IDLE. IDLE came with Python whenever you downloaded it. So you can always use that anytime. It is far like less complex and it does not have some of the features that PyCharm does. But if you really don't have a choice, then this is there for you. Now, I will get back to you in just a minute when PyCharm is ready. Hey guys, it's been about a minute and we are just about done downloading PyCharm. There's nothing specific that you have to do here. Just wait for it to download. And there you go. As you can see, Python has been installed on my computer. If you need more time, go ahead and pause the video. But if you are done, go ahead and click finish. And then go ahead and type PyCharm into your operating system's typing system. If you're using Mac, there should be a magnifying glass thing part up here. And if you're using Windows, go ahead and type it down here. If you're on Linux, there should be a button somewhere in this bottom right corner for you to type it. And yeah, just go ahead and set it to do not import settings, because if you have not downloaded PyCharm before, you don't need to install any settings. So, and then you go ahead and get there and just go ahead and skip remaining and set defaults. Comment down below if you like the background here. It's so good. It gets me every time. Okay, so here we are on the home screen. So what we're going to do is click create new project right here. We're going to click it. And then we're just going to go ahead and rename it to Hello World. And then just go ahead and make sure that your base interpreter is set to some sort of Python 3, because especially if you're on a Mac, it may be set to Python 2. So just really make sure it is on Python 3. And once you've done that, just go ahead and create it if you don't have any issues. So you're going to go ahead and click create. Yes. Oh, and this seems like a good amount. This seems like a good time to address. If you have any issues, go ahead and write it down in the comments and I will get back to you within 12 hours, I guarantee it. And so what you're going to do is go to File and click New. And if you are a little bit too early, it will show you Editor Config File. So you can either wait a little bit, or if you're a little impatient, what you can do is click on Hello World and then right click on that, click New, and then Python File. No matter where you do it from, whether you do it from here or from there, you have to make sure you click Python file. We're going to call it first lines.py. Make sure that you end in .py, because conventionally that's what all Python files end in, and you have to make sure that you end in that. We're going to go ahead and click enter. And as you can see, it has opened the file. So if you're ready to write our first line, let's go ahead. So we're going to go ahead and type print in all lowercase. Then we're going to do an opening and closing parenthesis. And you're going to do single or double quotes, or double quotes, or single quotes. And you're going to go ahead and type hello. And you're just going to go ahead and go to the run part, click run, and click first lines. Okay, this is what I wanted to address. You may have this error or a similar error. So here's what you're going to do. You're going to click configure Python interpreter, add interpreter, You're going to make sure it's set to the correct one. So we're going to make sure it's on Python 3.8. And you're going to make it available to all projects and click OK. That should solve the problem, but that may not be the case. So we're going to go ahead and test it. And as you can see, it has fixed the problem. And what do we have? Hello world. Beautiful. If you do have any other technical issues, I am there to help. Please put it in the comments down below. Okay, so we do need to end on a high note, so let's do this. Let's make a little dog. Print. We're going to do, an O for the face, and then some lines for the body. And we're going to do print, and a space, and four vertical lines for the legs. Actually, two spaces. And four vertical lines for the legs. Ooh, goodness. Yes, make sure you don't do that. Make sure you add your quotes first. Quotes, and let's print it. Print it. There we go. It's a little crusty, yes, but a dog nonetheless. So there you have it. We have our first couple of lines of code. In our next lesson, we will go into more detail on how Python works, and we will do a lot of formatting. So, see you then.